In less than 10 minutes, I'm going to show you the simplest and the easiest way to skin retouch your photos. Hi guys, my name is Eustace, and if you want to see more videos from me, please subscribe. Smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. Let's do this. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to remove the blemishes, the pimples. I'm going to do that using the frequency separation process. So let's do that. I'm just going to go to this background layer. I'm going to make a copy of this background layer. I'm going to Alt Control and then press J on the keyboard. So I'm going to make two copies. I'm going to select background copy one, the first one we made. I'm going to select this. I'm going to double click on it. And then I'm going to name this colors / low frequency. And then I'm going to select background layer two. I'm going to double click on it. And then I'm going to name it textures / high frequency. I'm going to disable the texture layer. I'm just going to click on this eyeball. And then I'm going to select the color layer. I'm going to go to filter. And then I'm going to select noise. And then I'm going to select dust and scratches. Let me just move this here. I'm going to take the radius down to one. I'm going to select a place in a photo that has a lot of textures, like this one right here. And then I'll start adding the radius until I stop seeing the blemishes or the textures or the pimples, but I can still see the features of the model's face. So 16 is okay. The threshold here, I'm just going to leave it at 0. If you move this side, you're removing the effect. And then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to enable the texture layer. And then I'm going to select it. I'm going to go to image. And then I'm going to select apply image. This is an 8-bit image. So we are doing the frequency separation for an 8-bit image. So on the layer here, I'm going to select the color layer, the one we made, the color / low frequency layer. It's the one that I'm going to put on merged here. I'm going to click here, and then I'm going to select the color / low frequency layer here. And then channel, we'll just leave it at RGB. The invert, we are not going to tick this. The blending option, we'll change the blending option to subtract because we are subtracting the colors from the texture layer. So I'm going to select the blending option here, and then I'm going to select subtract. Let me move this side. The opacity, I'm going to leave it at 100%. The scale, I'm going to use the maximum scale number of 2. The minimum scale number is 1. So I'm going to just select this one, and then I'm going to type 2 on the keyboard. So I want to subtract all the colors from the texture layer. So I'm going to set my offset to 128 because 128 is 50% gray. So I'm going to type 128 here. Click OK. I'm going to go to blending option here, and then I'm going to select these blending options because these blending options subtracts everything that's 50% gray. So I'm going to select the linear light here. I'm going to select the texture layer, and then I'm going to Alt Control on the keyboard, and then I'm going to select the color layer. I'm going to Alt Control and then press G on the keyboard, and then I'm going to double click here, and then I'm going to name this group as frequency separation. So now we have the frequency separation folder, so we can proceed with our retouching or removing the blemishes. So let me just show you one thing. So I'm going to open the frequency separation folder like this. I'm going to disable the color layer. I'm going to click on this eyeball. You can only see the textures in the texture layer. If I enable the color layer, if I disable the texture layer like this, we can only see the colors in the color layer. We don't have the textures in this layer. This layer, the texture layer, contains the textures. And then this color layer contains the colors. This is what frequency separation is all about. It's just to separate the textures and the colors so that you can work on the textures and the colors without affecting the other layer. Like you can work on the texture layer without affecting the color layer, or you can work on the color layer without affecting the texture layer. This is the simplest way I can explain the frequency separation process. I'm going to put the frequency separation action in the description. You can just download it and use it for free. I have these actions that you can use. They are going to speed up your retouching process. These actions are in my retouching actions pack. I'll put the link in the description if you're interested in my retouching actions pack. So let's say I have 10 photos that I'm supposed to sharpen. I'm going to Alt Control plus Alt plus Shift plus E just to merge this photo. Go to maybe image sharpening here, and then the Photoshop is going to do everything for you. This panel is going to pop up. This is where you're supposed to control how sharp you want your image to be. So let's proceed with our retouching. So now we are going to remove the blemishes. If you remember, we said the blemishes are in the texture layer. So I'm going to go to my frequency separation folder, and then I'm going to open it. I'm going to select the texture layer, and then I'm going to go to my tools, and then I'm going to select the crown stamp too. So let me move this side. I want this clean part to replace this pimple. So I'm going to alternate on the keyboard, and then I'm going to left click with my mouse to sample like this, and then I'll paint on the blemish or the pimple that I want to remove. I'll just left click here like this. I'm going to alternate on the keyboard. I'll sample this part, and then I'll replace the pimple with that clean part like this. I'll repeat this process until I remove all the blemishes from the image. I'll speed up this process. I'll see when I'm done. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to soften in the skin a bit. I'm going to select color layer here. I'm going to go to my tools here. And then I'm going to select the crown stamp too. Or I can just press L on the keyboard. I explained why I used the feather of 20 pixels in this video. After you're done watching this one, you should also check out this video. So let's proceed. So I'm going to make a selection like this. I'm going to go to filter. Then I'm going to select the blur. And then I'm going to select the Gaussian blur here. So let me put this side. So I'm going to take the radius back to 0.1. I'm looking at the photo here, and then I'll start adding the radius until I'm okay with how soft I want this part to be. So I'm going to use maybe the radius of 18, and then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to select this part like this, and then I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. I'm going to take the radius up a little bit, maybe 25. And then I'm going to click OK. I want to select this part. This part is soft already, so I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. So I'm going to use maybe the radius of 16, and then I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to select a nose like this. Then I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. So I'm going to use the radius value of 12. Then I'm going to click OK. So these are before, these are after, these are before. So after, the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to whitening the eyes. So I'm going to go to my actions. I'm going to click on this action button here, and then I'm going to select the teeth and eye whitening. I'll put the teeth and eye whitening action and the frequency suppression action in the description, or you can just download it and use it. So I'm going to just click on the teeth and eye whitening action here. I'm going to open the teeth and eye whitening, and then I'm going to select the photo filter here. Then I'm going to go to my tools. I'm going to select the brush, or I can just press B on the keyboard. Since the layer mask here is black, set the foreground color here to white. You can just click on this icon, or you can just press X on the keyboard to switch between the white and the black foreground color here. So I want the white foreground color. And then I'm going to zoom my photo just a bit. I'll make the brush a little bit bigger. I'll just paint this part like this. Move this side. I'll paint this part like that. These are before, these are after. So I want these eyes to look as realistic as possible. So I'm going to reduce the opacity to maybe 70%. So these are before, these are after. And then I'm going to go to my actions here. So I'm going to just click on the dodge, and then I'm going to go to my tools. With the brush selected, since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set the foreground color here to white. I'll make the brush a little bit bigger using the brackets on the keyboard, like this. And then I'll just paint this dark part of an eye. I'm going to just paint this. And then I'll move this side. I'll just paint even this. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. I'm going to select the light contrast here. This. So let me just zoom out a bit. These are before, these are after. So I've just added the contrast to the image using the light contrast action. I'm just going to reduce the opacity just a bit to maybe 50%. So these are before, these are after. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to color grade the image. I'm going to go down here on this circle. I'm going to click on it and then I'm going to select the color lookup. Let me just remove it from here. I put it maybe somewhere here. Let me just take this up like this. I'm going to color grade this photo using my Melanin skin tone pack. I'll put the link in the description below. I'm going to go on load 3D light here and then I'm going to select load 3D light here. I'm going to select the melanin tone one. So these are before, these are after. Let me just go back to my melanin skin tone pack. Let's try melanin tone 2. These are before, these are after. Let me just go back to my melanin skin tone pack. I'm going to select the melanin tone 3. So these are before, these are after. So I can just reduce the opacity of the LUT to maybe 35%. So these are before, these are after. Let me close this. So let me just change this color of the background so that it can just stand out more. So I'm going to go on this circle and then I'm going to select the color lookup. This color is in the blues. So I'm going to go on the colors here. I'll select the blues. I'll just drag the cyan all the way to 100 and then magenta 80 and then yellow. I'll take it to -100 and then blacks, -40. And then I'm going to go on colors here. I'm going to select the cyan. I'll take it to 100%, magenta 45%, and then yellows. I'll take it to -100 and then blacks, -65. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. And these are before all the adjustments. These are after, these are before, these are after.
If you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. So if you want to see how I shot these photos, you should check this video on top. And if you want to learn how to retouch in less than 10 minutes, you should check this video down here. I'll see you in the next one.